Good evening and welcome to the George J. Beck Fine Arts Center. As a courtesy to our performers, please silence all electronic devices, refrain from using flash photography, and remain seated until you hear applause. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming today. So, as you can hear, I'm not exactly from North Carolina. You know, somewhere across the ocean from Paris. But I live in New York, and I'm thrilled to be here today. I want to thank my friend and colleague, Dr. David Brooks, who made it possible for me to, you know, discover this beautiful campus and town and area, so I'm very grateful for that. I want to thank the music department, of course, for giving me the opportunity to come here and play for you and share a little bit of music together on this beautifully rainy day. So thank you for coming inside, and I hope we'll stay dry together. So I wanted to start this program with something sort of witty, and that piece I just played, I actually recently recorded it in a program that was around humor. And I wanted I recorded some pieces that had, or composers that had something to do with this humor element, whether it's funny or sarcastic or dark humor, etc. So this program is not fully related to it. However, later in the program we have a set of provocative pieces that is part of the album, and it's a different kind of humor. It's more sarcastic. You'll see the devil at the end. I don't know if that's really funny, but anyway, well, that's part of what I wanted to develop in this program. And the other two pieces I'm going to perform for you today are some French pieces, even though Chopin, the Polish people say he's Polish and the French say he's French. So I'm gonna segue into some more romantic virtuosic music with the Polonaise by Chopin, and at the end of the program I'll talk a little bit more about the last piece in the program. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks again for being here.
Thank you.
funny because I'm arachnophobic. Now I'm scared. How big was it? If there is a crawling spider, please feel free to come here and stomp it. we'll continue with... Now I'm really scared. We're gonna continue with an early set by Prokofiev that is not played very much, although the last piece is quite famous. It's called The Suggestion Diabolique. French title, he actually like wrote it as is, means the diabolical suggestion, devil suggestion. This one is like the famous crazy virtuosic piece. But the first three ones are not so popular, so I wanted to share those pieces with you. They are very, very beautiful, sort of post-romantic in some way. It's still early Prokofiev, I mean, we're here to learn about music, so might as well give you a little insight on early Prokofiev style, and that's what we're gonna discover together with this set.
Thank you.
Last but not least, a French piece for a French pianist and a French connection with Mr. Dr. David Brooks. So the last piece is La Vache de Ravel. I don't know if you guys know about it. It's a piece that Ravel originally wrote for orchestra. And it was supposed to be a ballet. But when he when he talked about this project to, you know, the ballet companies, they said in Diaghilev, the famous ballet Paris guy, said, nah, I'm not sure. Okay, well then Ravel was sort of in a pickle and he's like, what am I gonna do with it? So he decided to like make it an orchestra piece, but then he was thinking, okay, let's give it hope. Let's hope that maybe someday people will pick it up as a ballet. So he wrote different transcriptions, one for two pianos and one for solo piano. But the solo piano version he wrote is sort of a simplified version of the crazy piece that, you know, he originally wrote for orchestra. And I decided to spice it up a little bit, and I wrote my own transcription of it. And it was just to make a connection with Dr. David Brooks. I wrote the transcription during our doctoral studies together, and I premiered it in New York with one of his pieces. So just a little, I don't know why I'm advertising his output, but well, because it's beautiful music, and it's a very special piece to me for that reason, because I paired it with one of his pieces that I'm unfortunately not playing today, but maybe someday, you know, I'll come back and play all the pieces by the complete works of David Brooks. But in any case, so this is a sort of more punchy version of that piece that is basically a whole crescendo, sort of. It's sort of an arch crescendo going crazier and crazier. Just a little bit of context. It was a piece that was written right after the First World War. So there is a very dark element. And Ravel wanted to, like most of the French who always like to be ambiguous and, you know, second degree ironic, I don't know. He sort of wanted to combine somewhat Viennese-like light waltz and pair it with the disastrous consequences of the war. So that makes it an interesting cocktail. Hope you enjoy.